Hi guys, welcome to JESSEPT tutorial. In this session, I am going to explain couple of JESSEPT APIs which basically help you to encrypt and decrypt the integer formats. So there are basically three important classes available in the JESSEPT APIs, which is first one is the AES-256 integer number and encryptor. By using it basically uses to perform the high strength encryption of the big integer objects, and also the internal algorithm it is going to uses password based encryption with HMAC or SHA-512 bits and AES-256 bits. In order to obtain the key, the number of iterations which is required is the 1000. And let us go ahead and start with an example. Let me open my Eclipse and right click new class. Here let us say integer encryptors and click on this public static void main and click finish. Now the first class we are going to refer is AES integer 256 integer number and encryptor. AES 256 integer number encryptor equal to new AES 256 integer number encryptor, and we need to define the secret key. So in the earlier video I have used, this is the secret key. So let us consider the same secret key here, and we are going to basically set the secret key to the AES-256 integer or number encryptor object. So AES-256 integer number encryptor dot set password, and you can pass the secret key. Now basically this API is basically meant for to encrypt and decrypt the numbers. So for example, if you have any Aadhaar card number or any personal identification which basically stores as a number, then you can convert this number you can basically encrypt that number and decrypt that number using this particular AES-256 integer number encryptor class, or the you can say object. And once you have set the secret key, now using this AES-256 integer number encryptor object, we can basically do the encrypt. Now in order to do the encrypt, it basically expect the big integer. So we can say new big integer, and you can pass value here. Let us say 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. Okay, so this is basically my number I want to encrypt. So after encrypt, it will become the encrypted. I think it basically written as the big integer. Let us see what it is going to return. It is basically written the big integer. So you can capture that variable with the big integer, and he can say encrypted number. And once we have this encrypted number, let us go ahead and print this value. So it is encrypted number. Now if I go ahead and execute this program, right click run as Java application, then the encrypted number format will become unreadable. That means it will have a huge number, and if you see here, this is the corresponding to the whatever the number we provided. It is the encrypted number. Now if I go ahead and decrypt this number, then ideally we can get what is the plain integer number what we have provided. Now let us go ahead and decrypt it. So in order to decrypt, AES 256 integer number encryptor dot decrypt. Now I can pass this encrypted number here, and again this is going to return you the big integer, and let us consider that as a plain encrypted number. This is going to be like a decrypted number. Now let us print this decrypted number. So if you go ahead and print, if you print this decrypted number, then we can see the original number what we have passed to the encryption. Now if you see here, so 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, so this is the basically the input what we have given for this particular API before encryption. Okay, so this is the one of the important class, and the second one is basic integer. We have second class, which is basic integer number encryptor, and which basically works on the MD5 and DES encryption based on the password based encryption. Okay, now if I go ahead and run this program, you can run this output. So this is the encrypted number, and this is the after decrypt. And also we have one more, that is the strong integer number encryptor. Strong integer number encryptor. And now if I go ahead and import this, first we need to import this class. And let us go ahead and run this program again. So this is the encrypted format for the given number, and this is the decrypted number. Now if we see quickly the snapshot of these three algorithms, three classes. So the first one is AES 256 integer number encryptor, which basically work on the password based encryption with HMAC and SHA-512 and AES 256 bits. And basic integer number encryptor, this is basically used to normal strength of the encryption of the big integer objects. And the algorithm which basically used is the password based encryption with MD5 and DES algorithm. And a strong integer number encryptor, so this is class is used to perform high strength the encryption of the big integer objects, which basically using the password based encryption with MD5 and triple DES in order to obtain for the key iteration for the each algorithm is the 1000 times. Okay, so that's all we have about the JASIPT APIs for integer encryption and decryptions. Thanks for watching.